Minimum viable changes actually are small incremental changes. They're perceptible enough to make a change and make an improvement, but not large enough to actually cause disruption to the organization. The focus has always been on a large implementation with rollouts and timeframes. We worked with a large manufacturer that's in 45 different countries. One of the things they wanted to do was to change their DNA and the way they interacted with customers in the area of failing early, failing fast, and learning faster. So they realized to work with customers, you have to take some chances. But their organization was not set up to actually endorse that. So they realized the problem was actually the leadership. So the leaders themselves decided what they were going to do was to create a productive failure moment at the beginning of each of their meetings. What was the failure? What did you learn from that failure? How did you learn from that? What are you doing about it currently and going forward?
Smart factories is where a lot of change is happening in this industrial space. That's where you find a lot of people that have been working in these production lines for many years that have done things a certain way. We really worked hard to win those shop floor operators over by intentionally designing a system, by understanding their pain points. How could they do their job better? How could they be more efficient? As a result of that, they've improved the throughput of their plant by 20%. To them, the operator, this was just a way of really making their job a lot more effective and efficient and taking some of the doldrums out of the way they did their job. Eventually, that becomes just business as usual, and sort of the digital and traditional ways of doing business are really one, and there's a new organization that's created.